Hi, and welcome back to the Tech Lib YouTube channel. My name is Artur Schaefer, and I know that in your company, if you work with people all around the world, you have a language problem. Even though you speak just English on your support, maybe sometimes you have people that speak other languages or forget, or it's just hard to keep the English as the official language of the support area. Yeah, I know, I used to be an English teacher, and I'm not a native English speaker. As you can realize while I speak, I have a little bit of an accent, so I'm Brazilian, I just learned English, and sometimes I know it's hard to express my feelings or to express the issues, the incidents that I have in other languages besides Portuguese, that is my native language. And to solve that, sometimes we use translation tools to keep up to date with people and support. In GLPI, we have created a plugin called Translate, which is a plugin where you just click a button and all of the follow-ups or tasks are automatically translated to your language, the language which your GLPI interface is configured. So let's take a look at it. First of all, you're going to need the Translate plugin installed. If you have a valid basic subscription of GLPI Network, or if you are a GLPI Cloud client, you have access to this plugin, and you go to your marketplace and install it right there. To configure it, you just need to go to your General and Translate tab and put the API from Deeple. Deeple is a translation tool which uses neural and AI to give you translations in real time. And it has also an API, which is from free tire to corporate tire, and you should choose the correct tire for your organization. But if you use the free tire, you can surely use it in your daily basis. So here you can see we have a usage of 16%, for example, of our tire, and here we have some thresholds to receive notifications. Here also we have some target languages allowed for all users. If you want to add or if you want to disable any language, you can also disable it here. I'm just going to put all of the languages that GLPI has, and also translatable elements allowed for all users, for example, tickets, follow-ups, tasks, solutions, and approvals at this time. We are going to hit save, and we are going to open a ticket. So let's imagine here that we have a Portuguese speaker and we want to create a ticket, which says, I have no connection, but in Portuguese. I'm going to hit send it, and everything that I see here is in Portuguese because I am a Portuguese speaker. Can you see a button here? This is cool. Because right now we are going to the administration page for ticket number 2, and I can't understand because it's in Portuguese. So let's click here and see if it's in English now. Yes, it is. I'm not connected. So it helps too much in a way to support people here from other languages. Let's just create a new follow-up. So have you tried to reset the modem or the router? Add. I'm going to add also a task here. So analysis done, router seems to be connected. 5 minutes. Done. Add. And I will also ask for a validation from the user called Normal, which is an observer. So can you validate it? There's one thing that you also need to configure, which is the profiles that can use the translation. So every profile that should have access to translation should be also configured here. So we go to self-service, for example, and we activate the translations and items translation so they can also use the translation. Since we are using also the observer, it needs to have the translation enabled. Let's come back to the ticket. Let's open the self-service again and just update it. I can't understand English. Remember, it is in Portuguese and it uses the language that is set up here. So if right now I just hit here, it's going to be translated to Portuguese. And if I change it to, for example, Deutsch, I can also have it in Deutsch. Haben Sie versucht, den Router zu drucksetzen? I understand a little bit of German, and right now it's in German. The same thing we have for... Let me just put in Brazilian again. And... Funcionou. Obrigado. I'm going to add it. And let's come back here and validate it. But in this case, the validator or the observer is French. It just understands French. So I can go to the ticket as well, and I can see the validation here, and I can just translate it as well. So, pouvez-vous le valider? Então, eu posso falar português, je peux parler français, and I can also speak English in the same ticket or other languages if you have access to the DeepL API and the Translate plugin. Cool, isn't it? So I will just approve it. And I'm going to solve this ticket. Router was restarted. And it worked. So it was an automatic validation. And I can come back to the self-service. Solved. No connection. Router was restarted. Okay. Router was... O roteador foi reiniciado e funcionou. So, in this case, I use three languages in the same ticket, and everyone that could speak any of these languages could understand. But let's imagine that right now, someone in the company started to work, and this person just speak, for example, Spanish. Right now, I can see petición de validación, and I can also translate it to other languages since we have the plugin installed in our company. So remember, you just need the plugin, which is on our basic subscription or for all of our cloud clients. And you need also an API from DeepL, which is written like this, DeepL. This is the DeepL Translate. And on DeepL, you have four tiers. You have the free tier, the starter tier, and the advanced tier, and for sure the ultimate tier. Choose the one that fits better to your organization. In this case, we are using the free for this demonstration. But if you need more, you can go to other tiers. Create the API here. Use the API in your configuration. Translate. Add it here. And it's done. See you on the next video.